I can't imagine my life with shortage of water. Try living with a bucket of water for a day and you will know the importance of water. Let's see what kind of water problems India is facing and some solutions. The wettest desert. Mazandaram near Cherrapunji is the wettest place on earth. But so severe is the water shortage between months of November and March that the place becomes a desert. When the waterfalls and mountain springs run dry, its residents have to walk down the hill for several hours to fetch water from pipelines installed 25 years ago. The buckets are placed in the hand-drawn wooden carts and dragged uphill. Another option in the lean months is to buy water from tankers at rupees 10 to 15 per bucket. The last resort is to place an empty bucket under a leaky pipeline to collect the runoff water, because every drop counts. 1 million wells for Bengaluru. As soon as the lockdown was lifted in Bangalore, the manuvadars, or the traditional well diggers, sprang into action. As awareness of the value of harvesting water rises in the city amid severe water scarcity, their services are in demand. So far, the manuvadars have dug 113,000 wells. This is thanks to a project led by Mr. Vishwanath Srikanthaya to build 1 million recharge wells in Bangalore city. These are not bore wells that suck water out of the earth, but instead wells that put water back into it. They collect rainwater from rooftops and storm water drains and send it back into the earth. These wells are an ecological solution to many of the city's crises of water shortage, a shrinking water table, and urban flooding. Make hay while it pours down. There is a lesson for the whole country from Kerala's Maja Polima well recharge program. Started in 2008, it aims to use rainwater harvesting and groundwater recharge to revive 4.5 lakhs open wells that are the primary source of water in the state. Households received subsidies for well recharge from successive state governments. Now, Maja Polima is a people's program, with households seeing its benefits and adopting voluntarily. Between 2008 and 2017, 30,000 open wells were revived, benefiting 1 lakh families. The sweet taste of water and leisure. The Banishyam Nagar in eastern India, water used to mean hours of walking in the hot sun, long wait times in snaking queues, and frequently having to return with empty buckets. All that has changed with the installation of a hand pump in the village. Now, water time is associated with rest, along with life's most precious resource. The women of Banishyam Nagar have gained their time back. Delving deep for a drop. In the village of Dindori in Madhya Pradesh, you don't open the tap to get water. You walk miles in search of a well. Little children, young women, the able, the elderly, everybody walks. Once they find an open well, their task does not end. Now they have to descend into the depth of the well to haul water out. They use ropes and small footholds and climb down up to 40 feet to get a bucket of water. On every step, a person waits until the one below had filled her bucket. It is risky business. The footholds, if they are there at all, are tiny and slippery, barely sturdy enough to hold the weight of a child. A bucket, once filled, must last a family of four a long time before the walk and climb down are repeated. The water wives of Dengamal. Panibais or water wives are common in a village called Dengamal, western Maharashtra, where drought is common. It is a parched, rocky landscape with no water connections. The closest water source is the Batsa Dam or a well, both of which are a 12-hour round trip away. This journey is long and hard, leaving the women no time for household chores or child care. Men are mostly away at work as farm labor. So, the village has arrived at a unique solution to solve its problem. marrying another woman when first wife becomes pregnant, whose sole responsibility is to fetch water for the entire family. Hence the term water wives, or as they are most commonly referred to as Pani Bai. The answer is that he marries again and again so that they can go to fetch water for him and the family. It is this unusual connection with water that keeps the family together. A very expensive bath. Konnur is a hill station in Tamil Nadu. The sign near the bathtub in one of the Konnur's boutique hotel reads, "We are facing severe water shortage. We recommend that you take a bucket bath." While the hills receive a lot of rainfall, the water just runs off because of the lack of water harvesting or conservation measures. The hill stations are then dependent on water that needs to be pumped from the valley. The valleys are thickly populated and the demand for water is very high. In addition to this, a lot of energy is expended to pump the water uphill. If this mechanism is disrupted, there is no water. It is a long hike to fetch this water and an even more uphill climb to get this water home. One person's waste is another's water. The farmers of Kolar and Chikbalapur near Bangalore have been reaping the benefits of an ingenious experiment in wastewater recycling. As part of this project, treated domestic sewage water is being transferred from Bengaluru to these two parched districts. This water is then pushed into 126 lakes scattered around Kolar, many of them left dry by successive droughts. The aim is to regenerate the depleted groundwater and help farmers who rely on groundwater irrigation. Reviving taps and rising hopes. When the taps run dry in the cities, the water tanker riots begin. Women, men, and children get pushed just to get in line to put their bucket in front of the water tanker pipes. At least 35,000 Bangaloreans and Chennaites have been benefited. A startup called OECVO that believes that pure drinking water is not a privilege but a right invented water purifiers that are IoT, Internet of Things, enabled and provided a low-cost, efficient solution to this problem. These devices are installed in local community and workspaces to help people get drinking water at rupees 1 per liter, as opposed to anywhere between 40 to rupees 100 for a 20-liter water can, where you cannot even monitor the water quality. The greatest sucker of them all. India is by far the world's largest groundwater economy. Annually, we withdraw 3,000 cubic kilometers of groundwater, which is 25% of all the groundwater extracted globally. Our groundwater use is far ahead of US and China. India has over 35 million boreholes, again making us the world leader that suck groundwater out of the earth. Thank you so much for watching. Please like and share this video. For more interesting videos, subscribe to my channel. Thank you.